back. President Muhammadu Buhari has a described as unthinkable attempt by any Igbo man, most especially the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, to leave the country. This one happened today at Imo State. Buhari have really said a lot, as he mentioned about insecurity, and now he said that he wondered why some Igbo men are clamoring for separation. He made this as he said that fundamentally that Nigerians' growth and economy are all held by Igbo men. He added that they have successful businesses across the country, that Igbo men, Igbo as a whole, that it is unthinkable for them to leave the country. And these have been causing, people are really talking about it. Definitely, the president have seen that Igbo men, average Igbo men, is industrious. Igbo men generally are very hard working, that it is impossible for him to leave or to say, let Nigeria be separated, or let Igbo man, whose work and hard working styles have made the economy of Nigeria to be booming. If you are you, what will you do? It is only in the hands of the Lord that we will keep praying for this marginalization. And the president stated this on Thursday. You know, where a wife speaking at a town hall unit where the meeting was held with Southeast leaders during his one-day official visit to the state. Buhari's visit to Imo State came 2 months after the IPOB leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, was arrested overseas and extradited to Nigeria to face trial. And people have really talking about this. How will it be that during the time of detaining the leader of proscribed people of Biafra, and is also the time when he decided to visit Imo State, that in fact it is a mock and is a slap on the face of Igbos generally, whom he sees as much industrious than any other tribe, and that he really came, and people are really wondering what could be his reason of coming. And they now said, based on what we have gathered so far, that he came to commission some other project and to congratulate some leaders on Ezendibu, as now they have even denied that they are not part of his visiting the people that really came to welcome him, that Johannes and Igbo said they are not among of them. If you watch part of their pictures and their photographs, most of them are hiding themselves. Their nose masks cover their faces, and they are, I don't know, they are afraid, because they know that after Buhari must have gone back to Abuja, they will face their brothers who they have rebelled against. Also, the group called for a protest against Buhari's Imo State visit on Thursday, as maintained roads were empty and markets, shops, and that of road all are being empty for the sake of sit-at-home order given by the IPOB. A statement quoted that the president saying that with less than 2 years left in his 8 years tenure as the president of Nigeria, security would remain a major priority for his regime. A statement by the president spokesperson Femi Adesina, and titled, "I want to be remembered as the president who sustained Nigeria." President Buhari tells Southeast leaders why they should not leave Nigeria. All right, acknowledging the resourcefulness and the enterprising spirit of the Igbo people, the president said that the fundamental thing about the Igbo people is that there is no town you will see or visit in Nigeria without seeing the Igbos being in charge of their infrastructure or pharmaceutical industry. Therefore, it is unthinkable for me, as the president, that any Igbo man would consider himself not to be a part of Nigeria. Well, his visit have really seen the relevance and the importance of Igbo in the Federation, and if we, being the Igbo, the Ipob, and the Biafrans, are so much important and have this recognition right coming from the desk of the presidency, what is this kind of mistreatment and the marginalization that we are really suffering? Insecurity and the mistreatment coming right from the desk of the presidency against these people that are really booming the economy of the country. Well, to me and to any other person, as long as this is concerned, it is not really sounding well, and it is something that people are really talking about it. People are really saying their mind that this government is really marginalizing us, this government is really perpetrating so many things that people are really suffering. Therefore, it is unthinkable for him, as he said, that any Igbo man would consider himself not to be a part of Nigeria. Okay, the evidence he said is that there is for so everyone to see that Igbos are in charge of Nigeria economy. All right, my good people, this has been how it is. These are really making people to talk. And we will keep saying our mind, seeing the importance of Igbo man in this country. If you are in the shoe of presidents, will you let your people go? Let us not be mistreated. Let us do the needful. Let us know that we are all part and parcel of Nigeria. We shouldn't be called as being industrious. And when it comes to the things of placing and putting things in order, we are being marginalized. We are being called or regarded as minority. This is so painful, and people are really talking about it. This is just part of the grievance that seems to be levied against the visit of Mr. President to Imo State, and people are really not comfortable, and they are not well pleased for his. For his visit, because it's the time where he is being detained, the leader of Mazi Namdekano, the leader of indigenous people of Biafra, is being detained during that era. During that time, he decided to come to visit this state, the eastern part, and that is not really welcomed. And people that really came to witness or to welcome him are people that are really bought over by the governor, Hope Uzodinma. So most youths are being hired just to come and welcome him. And Ohanaeze Ndigbo, most of them cover themselves with nose mask. You barely notice or see them proper. And they know they are really blackmailing or kicking us, not being in good time with their brothers. And now it is the time for us to wake up and call the spade a spade. All right, my good people, let's have your take from here. Please do to tap on the subscription button for more update. Thank you, and God bless you.